And I began to feel a new peace in my heart. I knew it was the voice of the angel of God. But don't you ever hear God's voice? When sin stands before you, when you see you're doing something you're not supposed to, doesn't something inside of you say it's not good, don't do it? Doesn't it?
You know,
this is the voice of the angel of God. He tells you not to do evil. But see, then the devil comes. Hey, look, you can sin. David sinned. He was still king. God forgave him. Brothers, let's not deceive ourselves. David was a king. He was under the law. And in the old days, you could sacrifice animals for your sins. But for our sins, there was Christ who died. And through his wounds we're healed. And through his blood we're cleansed of all sin.
Amen. Am avut un meeting la Mormoni.
We had a meeting with the Mormons
in Utah. Vreau să vă spun ca să nu vă las nespus.
I'd like to tell you a bit about it so that you know you won't be.
Sunt mormoni.
But you know how Mormons are.
Au fost atâta popor că nu pot să nume.
And there were so many people in there.
Și când am început să le spun.
And I began to speak to them.
Voi credeți în cartea lui Mormon?
You guys believe in the Book of Mormon?
Voi credeți în cartea lui Joseph Smith?
And in the Book of Joseph Smith?
Dar în cartea aceasta voi nu credeți.
But you're deceived. You should believe
Adivărata
in this book.
Carte.
The only true book.
Care ne poate duce în fericire.
You know, it's not the Book of Mormon, and it's not the Book of Joseph Smith. It's not the Book of Duduman. The only true book is the Bible. All the Mormons stood up, and they began to yell hallelujah. I had no idea what was happening. At the end I found out. All of them saw an angel of the Lord coming down. So that they understand what we say is from the Spirit of God. And God brought out many people from among them. I pray God work among your hearts too. You know, the Mormons accepted us very well. But then they began to hate us because so many people were excommunicated. Still, they saw the power of God. You know, I pray that you feel the power of God, not see it.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Brothers, I was on the Black Sea for 2.5 years. Very many missionaries came through. You know, they would tell one another. And so I would help them all. I was full of joy now. I knew that I was doing something for God.
You know,
I felt this joy in my heart.
You know,
I knew I was helping someone take in the Word of God. But after 2.5 years, they began to persecute the Christians. Communist government ordered all Christian children, no matter what rank, to go home. I had to go home also. But I was very sad. I went with the thought of taking revenge on my parents. Because they were Christians, I lost my job. My mother saw that I was sad. So she said, "What's wrong with you, son? Why are you so sad?" I said, "Well, because you're Christians, they kicked me out of the army." "Where's dad at?"
"La adunare."
"He's in church." "Well, then I'll go embarrass him there," I said. She said, "Wait, don't go, he'll be home soon." But I said, "No, I'm going there." When I got to the door of the church, they were singing such a beautiful song, like you guys sang this morning. But I'll never forget this one song. I'll tell you a verse of it. Long ago he came from above, the good shepherd Jesus Christ. And he traveled throughout the world looking for lost sheep. I thought, I'm the lost sheep. I ran away from home, and Christ found me on the Black Sea. I began to cry, brothers. Simțeam că bate ceva la inima mea.
I felt something knocking at my heart.
Aș vrea să simt și tu.
I would like you to feel the same.
Era ciocanul Duhului Sfânt.
The hammer of the Holy Spirit.
Plângeam, nu mă puteam opri.
You know, I was crying and I couldn't
Am
stop.
Am udat 3 batiste.
I wet 3 handkerchiefs.
Mi-era rușine că plâng.
I was embarrassed how I was crying.
De ce plâng eu?
I'm a man.
M-am uitat o dată în adunare să văd dacă mai plânge cineva.
I looked in the church to see who else was crying.
Plângea tata de bucurie că m-a văzut la adunare.
Only my dad was, because he was happy he saw me in church.
Apropii de tata, și tata, dar eu de ce plâng?
So I go to him and I said, Dad, why am I crying? He said, I'll tell you at the end of the service. At the end, he asked me to stand. And he said, Dumitru, are you really sorry to get you out? I said, yes, I am, Dad. Then he said, look, brothers, the answer to our prayers. We have been praying for 2 years that he be kicked out. Then he said, God needs officers in his army also. Now you must come to God, son. I said, I will, Dad, but let me get married first. He said, good, marry a girl from our church. I said, can't from here, they're all poor. So he said, go find a rich one, just come to God.
Well,
I went and I found Maria, brothers. Maria was an orphan, she was poorer than those in the church. But she was very beautiful.
And
I liked her a lot, so I said, if you come to God, I will marry you. I married her when she was 17 years old.
Și avem 37 de ani.
And it's been 37 years.
Acum 2 zile am împlinit 37 de ani de la nuntă.
2 days ago was our 37th anniversary.
Hallelujah! Fraților,
Brothers, I married Maria.
M-am dus la adunare.
We began to go to church.
Am încheiat legământ cu Dumnezeu.
We committed ourselves to God.
Am stat în rugăciuni multă vreme până am primit puterea de la Rusalii.
We prayed for a long time until we received the power of God.
După ce am primit puterea de la Rusalii,
after receiving the power of God,
am început să predic Evanghelia.
I began to preach the gospel.
Și mergeam peste multe biserici.
I went through many churches.
La noi și la noi sunt foarte multe biserici.
And in our country there are very many churches.
În schimb, pe vremea aceea erau bisericile la subsol.
But in those times the churches were underground.
Ne adunam și ne rugam lui Dumnezeu cu pernele în geamuri.
We'd gather and we'd put pillows in the windows. We'd lock all the doors. Many times in basements. In the forest.
Și ne rugam lui Dumnezeu.
And we'd pray to God.
Făceam cina Domnului.
We'd have communion.
Și eram plin de Duhul Sfânt.
And we were full of the Holy Spirit.
Și Dumnezeu ne întărea.
And God would strengthen us.
Și tot aduce oameni la pocăință.
And he'd keep bringing new people into the kingdom of God.
Mergând prin biserici, am văzut că nu avea Biblie.
Traveling through churches, I saw there were no Bibles.
Întrebam de pastor, de ce nu aveți voi Biblie?
I would ask the pastors, why don't you have any Bibles? While I was on the Black Sea, many Bibles came in. And the pastors would say, brother, the Bibles came in through communist hands. The communists sold them to us. The next day they sent the police and the police confiscated them. And we're still left without any Bibles. When I heard this, I went and spoke to my family. And once again I went to the Black Sea. I went to the chief of the shipyard and I said, chief, I have gotten married. I have no job. Please give me a job here.
Băi, pentru pocăiți n-am servici.
But I have no jobs for Christians.
Doamne, dar ce să fac? Eu n-am făcut decât școala militară.
But sir, what do I do? I came here to Marine school.
Primește-mă măturător în port.
He said, let me be a trash cleaner around here at least.
Băi, Dumitru, nu te pot vedea la mătură.
He said, but Dumitru, I could not see you with a broom in your hand.
Dar ce să fac, domnul comandant?
Then what do I do, sir?
Băi, stai un pic.
He said, hold on a minute.
Tu știi să faci mâncare?
Do you know how to cook?
Zic, da, știu.
Oh, yes, I do.
Merg bucătar la popotul ofițărească.
Then go cook in the cafeteria.
Și acolo am să te plătesc foarte bine.
I will pay you very well.
Acolo trebuie să ajung, fraților.
That's where I had to be, brothers.
Nu m-am dus că n-aveam cu ce trăi.
I didn't go because I had no money.
Tata meu era bogat.
My father was a wealthy man.
Dar m-am dus cu gândul să mă întâlnesc cu misionari.
But I went to be able to meet the missionaries.
Misionarii nu dau niciodată adresa precisă.
Because missionaries never left their exact address.
Și când am intrat, am stat 2 luni bucătar.
And so I cooked for 2 months.
Acolo m-am învățat să răb.
That's where I learned how to suffer.
Acolo toți își băteau joc de mine.
Because everyone would mistreat me there.
Spunea, rabdă, Dumitru.
But I say, suffer, Dumitru.
Hristos a răbdat mai mult ca tine.
Christ suffered much more than you.
După 2 luni de zile.
Well, after 2 months.
Am auzit aceeași voce din vapor.
I heard the same voices from the ship.
Dumitru fugi la bordul vaporului că vine din.
Dumitru run to the pier of the ship. Dig is coming in.
A fugit fuga la bordul vaporului.
I ran to the pier.
Primul om care a ieșit din vapor.
And the first man who got out was Brother Dig.
Eu de sus i-am zis, pacea Domnului, frate.
From far away I said, peace of God unto you, Brother Dig.
Pentru că noi creștinii români ne salutăm pacea Domnului.
Because the Romanian Christian greeting is peace of God unto you.
Creștinii americani zice, hai și bai.
The American Christian greeting, hi and bye.
Fratele Dick, când m-a văzut civil, a început a plânge.
Well, when Brother Dick saw me in civilian clothing, he began to cry.
Nu știa ce s-a întâmplat cu mine.
He didn't know what had happened to me.
Și ne întâlnim la hotelul 2 Constanța.
So he said, let's meet in the second hotel in Constanța.
Pentru că noi românii nu putem să fi stat de vorbă cu străini.
Because we Romanians were not allowed to talk to foreigners.
Dacă m-a prindea că stau de vorbă cu un străin,
if I was caught speaking to him,
îmi dădea 6 luni de închisoare.
I'd have about 6 months of jail.
M-am dus la hotel.
I went to the hotel.
Acolo ne-am rugat împreună.
There we prayed together.
Și împreună am plecat la București.
And together we left for Bucharest.
La București l-am întâlnit pe fratele Andrew.
There we found Brother Andrew.
L-am întâlnit pe fratele Harlan Popov.
Brother Harlan Popov.
L-am întâlnit pe fratele Wurmbrand.
Brother Richard Wurmbrand.
Și alți frați.
And other brothers.
Am făcut o legătură strânsă.
We made a strong pact.
Ei să aducă Bibliile în România.
They would bring the Bibles into Romania.
Eu să le dau la biserică.
And I would give them to the churches.
Și într-o perioadă de 3 ani de zile.
And within about 3 years.
Majoritatea bisericilor
românești. Most of our churches had Bibles.
Bisericile se rugau pentru noi.
The churches continued to pray for us.
Și Dumnezeu ne păzea.
And God protected us all the time.
Pentru că era dat un decret de lege la noi în România.
They had just passed a new law in Romania.
Toți care vor fi prinși, care are legătură cu străini.
All of those caught having contact with foreigners.
Sau dă Biblie la alții.
Or giving Bibles to other people.
25 de ani de închisoare.
25 years of jail.
Și confiscarea averii.
And the confiscation of all material wealth.
Tot timpul eram cu viața la risc.
So your life was always in danger.
Dar aveam credință că Dumnezeu ne păzea.
But we had faith that God would protect us.
După 3 ani de zile.
After 3 years.
Dumnezeu a ascultat rugăciunea bisericilor.
God heard the prayer of the church.
A trimis o ploaie puternică peste România în 1970.
And in 1970, after they closed the borders, God sent intense rain.
A fost că jumătate din țară a fost în apă.
It rained so hard that over half the country was flooded.
Când guvernul comunist a văzut atâta pagubă,
when the communist government saw so many losses,
au cerut ajutor Occident.
They asked for the foreigners' help.
Au deschis granița.
They reopened the borders.
Și au început să vină Biblie liberă.
And Bibles started coming in freely.
4 ani au venit liber Biblie.
For 4 years, Bibles came in freely.
Dar frații nu mai aveau Biblie românești.
The brothers had no more Romanian Bibles.
Au trimis foarte multe Biblie rusești.
And so they sent over many Russian Bibles.
Eu am locuit la 18 km de granița rusească.
I lived only about 18 kilometers away from the Russian border.
Am făcut mari depozite de Biblie.
And so I hid a lot of Bibles everywhere.
Nu mai știam unde să le mai pun.
I didn't know where to hide them at anymore.
Căutam să le trec dincolo.
I tried to take them over.
Dar nu puteam.
But I just couldn't.
Și am venit acasă foarte supărat.
I came home very sad.
Că mă urmărea poliția.
The police began to follow me.
Și când m-a văzut tata galben la față.
Oh, my dad saw my face pale.
Băi, Dumitru, tu ești bolnav?
He said, Dumitru, are you sick?
Zic, nu.
I said, no.
Dar ce ești galben, băi, la față?
Then why is your face so pale, son?
Tata, am atâtea Biblii rusești.
Well, dad, I have so many Russian Bibles.
Nu mai știu unde să le pun.
I have no idea where to hide them at anymore.
Să le trec dincolo și n-am putut.
I keep trying to take them over, but I just can't.
Ai vrut tu, băi?
He said, you tried to?
Zic, da, eu.
I said, yeah, me.
Băi, tu te-ai rugat?
Did you pray first?
Zic, nu.
Well, no.
Ai postit, băi?
Did you fast?
Zic că nu.
Well, no.
Ai întrebat de Dumnezeu?
Did you ask God about this?
Zic că nu.
Well, no.
Te bizui pe tine, băi, de ce n-ai dus?
You trusted yourself. That's why I couldn't take him over.
Ia, hai, băi, să ne unim să postim.
Let's unite and fast.
Să ne rugăm lui Dumnezeu.
Let's pray to God.
Și să vină Dumnezeu să-ți arate.
And God will come and show you a way.
Fraților, că azi ne-am hotărât.
Brothers, we decided that day.
Și seara nu eram adormit bine.
And that night, I wasn't fully asleep.
Odată am simțit o mână scoală, Dumitru.
And I felt a hand wake up, Dumitru.
Am sărit drept în picioare.
I jumped up.
La capul patului meu.
And at the head of my bed.
Era un om îmbrăcat într-o haină albă.
There was a man dressed in a white robe.
Și eu când l-am văzut am început să tremur.
When I saw him, I began to shake.
M-am uitat la ușă, zic, pe unde-a intrat?
I looked at the door, you know, how did he get in?
Ușa încuiată, geamurile închise.
Door was locked, windows closed.
Cine-i ăsta, pe unde-a intrat?
Who is he? How did he get into my house?
Dumitru, nu te teme, zice.
He says, Dumitru, don't be afraid.